Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to run PHP programs on Visual Studio Code. So I am going to write a hello world program on PHP and I am going to show you how to use three different plugins like IntelliFace, Code Runner, then PHP Server, and using all these different plugins, how you can easily run that on browser, on console, and all that. Alright. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch this video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always comment me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there. You can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to run PHP on Visual Studio Code, you will basically need two things. One is PHP itself and then Visual Studio Code. So for that, just simply go to favorite browser and just simply type PHP download and hit enter. So we are going to first download PHP. So go to this link and here you need to scroll down and you need to click on this Windows download. I am downloading it for Windows. So I'm following that process. If you are using some other operating system, you need to switch to this download and need to download to respect to that operating system. Here we are going to download this ThreadSafe one. So under ThreadSafe we'll get a zip, click on that, and it's going to start downloading our PHP. Next thing that we'll need is Visual Studio Code. So open a new tab and type Visual Studio Code, and that will show you this code.visualstudio.com. go to their official site of Microsoft and click on this download for Windows. So thanks for download, our Visual Studio Code is also rightly started downloading. I have already Visual Studio Code and PHP downloaded, so I'll cancel both. I'll minimize my browser, I'll go to my download directory, and you can see both Visual Studio and PHP is rightly downloaded over here. So let's first extract our PHP. Right click on extract all and click on extract. So that's going to start extracting our PHP over here. You can see it is rightly started doing that, and it is rightly done and also opened. So close this. So PHP is rightly extracted. Next thing that you need to do is you need to rename this. So right click and click on show more options and rename, and rename this to little shorter name. So keep like PHP dash then the version. Alright, so at the time of making of this video, version is 8.4.2. when you will be watching, you might see a different version, but you don't need to worry. So you need to just follow the same process what I'm showing. Alright, so just extract it and rename and cut this folder and go to your C drive and just simply right click and paste that PHP folder over here. Now just go inside that folder and click on this address bar, right click and copy this path. Now go to search and type environ, click on this edit the system environment variable, click on environment variables and click on path and click on edit and new, right click and paste that PHP path over here, click on OK, again OK and again OK. And now we can close this folder also, go to a download directory. So now that our PHP is actually installed, you can also verify it. Just go to search and type cmd to open your command prompt and let's verify it. So just simply type php space dash dash version, hit enter, you will get this type of prompt. Then all that basically means is your PHP is rightly installed. So close this. So now that our PHP is rightly installed, it's time to install Visual Studio Code. Just simply double click on the installer, accept the license agreement, click on next, next, again next, and check all these different options and click on next. Again ready to be installed, click on install. You can see our installation is rightly began. Let's minimize our download directory. So by the time our Visual Studio get installed, I request you please to consider subscribing our channel Geeky Syntax along with our main channel Geeky Script, so that going to really motivate me to make more this kind of videos. And also if you want, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. And recently I'm posting a lot of videos on WordPress, e-commerce, so I'll recommend you please to also watch my other videos on this channel. That's going to really motivate me to make more this kind of videos. So welcome back. So you can see that our Visual Studio is rightly installed, also desktop shortcut created, launch Visual Studio Code is also checked, click on finish. That's going to launch our Visual Studio Code. So let's expand it, and this is the interface of our Visual Studio Code. So here let's close this welcome note, and let's click on this Explorer and click on open folder, and let's on our desktop create a folder. So create a new folder, and let's name this folder as php-workspace, and just simply select that and click on select folder. So our PHP workspace folder is rightly selected. Here you can click on these items, the authors and all. So our PHP workspace folder is rightly selected and opened also. Now it's time to install some of the plugins. So go to these extensions and just simply search over here PHP. So that's going to show you all these different plugins. So here I'll recommend you to select this third one, that is PHP IntelliFence, and it is developed by Ben Mewburn. So just install it. Our installation is rightly done. Let's scroll down and let's see their quick start note. So here it is telling to disable this PHP language feature. So let's search with this @ built-in PHP, copy it and just type it over here and paste, and let's go to this PHP language features and disabled it. Alright, so yeah, so now that it is disabled, so let's go back to your PHP boxes folder again. Let's click on this new file and let's name this file as index.php and hit enter. So that will open this index.php over here. You can write your code here, PHP code, so angular bracket PHP, close that angular bracket, and just simply echo hello world over here, hello world, and just save this file. I'll recommend you to install one more plugin called Code Runner. So Code Runner, just search on these extensions, you'll get this Code Runner, install it. You can see that it is rightly installed. Go back to your code and you will get this run button generated over here. So click on this run code and you will get the output hello world on our console. Right, so in this way you can easily create a PHP program on Visual Studio Code and you can run that. I'm going to also show you about another plugin called PHP Server. So just simply search with PHP Server, that will show you this PHP Server over here. Install this plugin as well. So it is rightly installed. So now if you again go back to your code and right click, you will get this option called PHP Server Serve Project. So click on that. So that's going to start a localhost server on 3000 port and going to show you that output on our console. So if you are changing anything on your code, so let's say hello world to hello everyone, and saving this file, and on our browser, if you are just simply refreshing it, you'll get that modified output on your browser, right? So in this way, you install this PHP server and you can run your PHP code on browser as well. Alright, so yeah, so that's how you use Visual Studio Code for PHP programming. Hope my videos are helping you. If these videos are really helping you, don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Script along with our Geeky Syntax channel. And also, if you're interested, you can also watch my other WordPress videos. As you know that WordPress is also written in PHP. So I'll highly recommend you to watch all these different videos. Alright, so yeah. So that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.